Ago and more, in an Asian kingdom, now known as Cambodia, there lived a king who was exceedingly kind and just, and his queen who was extremely beautiful. The people's pleasure in their royal sovereigns would have been complete, except for one thing. There was no heir to the throne. One fine night, followed by her attendants, the queen sought the coolness of the palace gardens. Her eyes took in the beauty of the old temple buildings, and her lips smiled, but in her heart there was little joy. For there would be no one to inspire her people to create and to build for the future generations to come. She knew that although her husband, the king, did not say it, in order not to hurt her feelings, his mind and heart yearned for a son who could inherit the throne. And the queen, hovered over the kingdom like a depressing cloud. So in her soul, she prayed that God take pity and endow on her a son. Thus she prayed, while outwardly seeming to be happy, deeply hiding her sadness and despair. Suddenly, from out of the heavens, a blaze of green light fell, astonishing the queen and her maids. Indra Pinsurkea, the supreme god of the Tavatimsa. From his heavenly abode, he had looked earthward and taken pity on the sorrows of their majesties. He decided to perpetuate their dynasty. Upon the queen he showered fragrant blossoms. From the celestial flowers, the queen conceived, and in due time would give birth to a son. This son she would name Preya Ketmalaya. the queen confided that she had conceived from the flowers.
បងអីបងទួលវិលេសបានអីខ្ញុំភ័យណាស់បងទួលវិលេសបានអីកុំបួយទៅអីសំលៀកទៅបានវិលេសបោះហើយខ្ញុំមិនចាស់ឃើញគ្នាពេញប្រអងមិនអីណាបាញ់ចឹងអីទេបងអ្ហេទួលវិលេសបានអីមិនហើយទេតែខ្ញុំដូចជាមិនស្រួលខ្លួនសោះចិត្តញ័រអង្គខ្លួនបងមិនដឹងថាវិលេសបោះធ្វើទុកអីណាបាញ់ចឹងជាងគិតនាំគ្នាទៅបងទួលវិលេសបានអី
At nearly the same time, a goddess was condemned by Indra for stealing six flowers from a painter. For 6 years must she live on earth as the wife of this mortal. Do not prostrate yourself to me, said the goddess, for I was sent by Indra to be your wife. A son, Prayalpiznikar, was born from this union of goddess and artist. So great was his genius for building and sculpture that Indra placed him under the tutorship of the builder gods. On his knees, Prayalpiznikar awaited his lord, Prayaketmalaya. Both had grown into manhood, and Prayaketmalaya was on the eve of his coronation. Prayaketmalaya, too, had visited the abodes of the gods. He had taken a fancy to their dwellings, and had ordered Prayalpiznikar to build their replicas in his realm. Prayalpiznikar had obeyed.